town, get down to Dr. Schöning and I feel quite like in a way to speak of the architecture, but I'm speaking about architecture, and that we be aware that while we see no building, I'm speaking about architecture. To explain a bit the way I'm seeing now architecture, because I did feel quite a lot of buildings in
Van Oudijk, connected to the Rijksacademie in Amsterdam. I'm an art historian and also responsible within the Academy for International Project, or as Bruce calls it, International Affairs, Cultural Affairs. Behave yourself. Well, this afternoon you will get to see the work of 8 different artists connected to the Rijksacademie, whether as participant or as staff member. It will be 2 persons will show videos, the others slides. It will be mainly the work, with the exception of Peter Struiken, who will give us some broader outline about his work. I will just say the names that you have any idea who it are, but one after each other will say again who he is. We will start with Christian Zwaneken, then Lisa Post, Pim Komen, Peter Struiken, Filia den Hollander, Simon Watkinson, Apollonia Susternik, and Anna Best. And I think that in general what is parallel in their work, although it's quite different work, but the parallel is that they're all on a kind of borderline in relation to more traditional art, a borderline whether between art and architecture, whether or between art and technology. Is everyone sitting? Okay, then I'd like to introduce Christian Zwaneken.
Good afternoon. My name is Christian Zwaneken. I would like to show you a tape of my work. My work consists of the main part of kinetic work in the sense that I use or try to use movement in a mechanical, electronical way to express myself or to use it as an artistic means. I'm now a student at the Rijksacademie, but before that I studied at the Rietveld and had a sculptural training. Before that, I tried to make films. I was very interested in film because the use of motion and sound I really liked, and I was fascinated by it. And I think the best thing is to show the tape, and if there are really specific questions, we can interrupt the tape about anything you would like to ask. I mean, that's the advantage of video. So yeah, maybe we could see it now. Yeah, there's one more thing I would like to say about the video, that I start with the latest show I had of my pieces, which are in a way connected with each other in a kind of network, and so I will start to show that, and then I will go slowly back to the things I did before, which are much more objects and related to sculpture, and I hope that you see a kind of development, but then in the other way around. So I go from now to a little bit before, so that's 5 years. Could you leave the sound as loud as possible, please? Thank you. I don't know if I should continue and or I think I would like to stop the tape here. Well, I hope you get some idea about my work. I think there's still a lot to discuss about kinetic art, in the sense that it has been a very strong movement in the 60s, but then it suddenly disappeared. And when I started to make this work, I actually didn't have this notion. For me, it was very natural to use it as a means to make art. And while I was working on it the last few years, I encountered a lot, in a way, a lot of resistance or a lot of discussion and about this way of working. But maybe we, in discussions after this, we could talk a little bit more about that, and that I leave my seat to the next one.
My name is Lisa Post. I'm just started at the Rijksacademie this year. First few slides I show from work. I'll just start, go along with the slides, so it's easy. This is a few years ago, 20 minutes in, let's say, the Dutch Harrods. I also have it on a film, and I would call it a more, let's say, emotional approach to the architecture of a perfume department. Because all the smells of the different perfumes, they become more like lethal from the hospital. So I would rather like to faint in a place like this than to buy anything. The next few slides, there's work by which I was chosen to harder. There's work in which I was, after which I was asked to participate in a project called the Seven Museum. But we come to that later. I will first show the next slide, please. This is my own house. After some period that I didn't want to see anything anymore, and I wanted to leave and at the same time enter the place, and by making a photograph of this completely white hidden room, I wanted to show whether you can leave or stay at the same time. Okay, next slide, please. This is my part of a table exhibition which happened in a place in Amsterdam called W139, and that's an artist, independent artist exhibition space. And I actually sat like this for 2.5 hours amongst several other tables which were exhibited, and then afterwards I took a photograph of it, and now always the discussion goes about whether the picture is the work or the actual doing is the work. So that also seemed to be the discussion. Okay, next slide, please. This is for me a very private memory, which I tried to do again. This is a hospital, and for me this is a view I had as a young child, sitting under a hospital bed and not knowing whether the nurses were the ones that are the ones that cure or are to be cured. The next, please. This is a corner in the courtyard of Holland's oldest prison, and this is part of the Seven Museum, which is a project in The Hague, in which several artists were asked to do their work, and let's start again. In the center of The Hague, there's the buildings of Parliament and several museums, the Maurits House, which shows the Vermeers, the old Vermeers, and a lot of other paintings. So it's, you enter a space which is very old, very Dutch, very small, and this, when I was asked to make work for these spaces, I chose in the several institutions around the pond. The pond is the center of the, is, let's say, the quite humid center of our Dutch parliament. And I chose spaces which are not specifically inside the museum or outside. And I walked around there for a couple of weeks, and thinking about being Dutch, being in this very Dutch place, thinking about power, think about social, our social state, I call it the state of care. This was, let's say, the outcome of the state of care. The next one is a little bit further away. I couldn't get further away to show the whole thing. Later on I have a video in which you can get more a grip on how the place is feeling. Okay, next slide, please. This is also in the prison. There's a little space on the corner where the ones that didn't recover from the torture, because it's also a torture museum here. You have this site with thumb screws and things from Middle Ages, and when people get a tour, they enter the courtyard and then they see this picture and this one. So this is next one, please. This is another museum along the pond. It's the Bredius Museum. It contains a lot of old paintings, all by dead artists. And for these institutions, it was for the first time that they let someone make work inside their let's say old, and I think the way they treated me sometimes was rather difficult. So they took away this picture without saying it, or before the ending of the exhibition it was gone, because another member of the Seven Museum made work which contains three toilets, and they thought it was very banal, and that's why my work also was taken away. This shows the sort of posh, I think that's the word, way they are there. This is a woman who is dressed as a judge. She's 74 years old. She has purple hair. Many women in The Hague have purple hair. It's supposed to be gray, I think. And there's a sink, an old marble sink, which doesn't work anymore. And this is sort of sticking out of her belly. And she shows her age by showing her neck. And also, she shows a lot of, I think old power. Next slide, please. Oh, this is a view from the stairs. Next slide, please. This is the William V hall. This is a small gallery of William V's own collection. And the only thing alive in this place for me was the supposed. And that's why I portrayed him as a young man. So this is the young supposed. This long thing in the middle is a picture taken inside the mirror, reflecting the other side where the paintings were hanging. So if you would enter the room, you would see a little boy standing, watching you, and then you would discover that it's not a mirror. Next one, please. Here you see him a little bit more clearly. Next one, please. This is the entrance of the Hague Historical Museum. On the right side, there's a window in which you look at the courtyard. And on the window of the courtyard, there's installed a picture. And actually, the window you see is also the picture. It's not a real window. And next slide, you can see it a bit more clearly. There's two men standing closely to Bush. And next slide, please. This one is in the Maurits house. This is the most, the richest of them all. Here are also the Vermeers. And this is the coffee house of the Maurits house. And while I was thinking about making work here, I thought that to get on the same level of this, or to make these people inside this building all the same level, you not only have to undo them from their clothes, but you also have to take off their skin to make them equal. And that I thought that you have to start at a young age to put some pressure against this meat. So that's a child's hand putting pressure on the meat. Next slide, please. While people having their ham sandwich and coffee, they, after seeing the old paintings, I think this is the last one. Yes.
Right.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Pim Coleman, and I'd like to show three installations. Roll it. The first one is a computer installation, a spin-off of something I want to do in public space, in a waiting area of an airport or train station, on those boards where you normally see the arrival times. But this is a spin-off, it's called, Fall Edward Fireplace. Please. And it's two computers, a monitor, and a heating element.
Thank you.
And I sell the tapes to people who don't have a fireplace and can put it in the telly and stare into it. This is an installation I did in the same W139 that Lisa mentioned. It's 12 nervous girls, and I picked one thing that they did when they were nervous, and I looped it. So it goes on and on and on forever. And this is the last. These are taped car phone conversations of people who are unaware that they're being taped. And the images are things filmed with a hidden camera. And it's four fragments because the entire thing is 27 minutes.
Nee, maar al wat je moet, al wat je zelf ook, al wat je weet zelf ook niet wat je wilt.
Stop the tape, yeah? Please. Any questions? Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.